Good morning, everyone. We are slightly delayed, and you know, Milan speaks after me, so he's requested me to wrap through my session, so I'm going to try and make this as fast as possible, right? So only for you, Milan. All right. My topic is mistakes that marketers you know, should avoid while doing content marketing. And I'll quickly jump to the first mistake. The problem is that marketers know their brands really, really well. They live, breathe their brands, their brand promise, their brand positioning, day in and day out. And what that ends up doing is they end up translating a lot of that into content. Now, that may make sense for marketers in trying to create awareness, but users out there are looking for content that can affect them emotionally, entertain them, you know, make them share it, and not really looking to your information or a brochure or a PR article about your brand, until unless they are searching for your brand and looking out for it. Today, content is discovered on the go while they are browsing through feeds, and that's when they stop. It's called thumb-stopping creative, thumb-stopping content. And they only stop when they see something that interests them or that catches their eye or something that's going to entertain, excite, or make them emote. So making an ad and expecting results like it's great content is the first mistake. And a lot of marketers while trying to create content for their brands. The second is focusing on features or the brand promise and forgetting to tell a story. So while you can highlight the features and the brand promise, that can't be the core of your story that you're telling. The story has to be a human story. We connect with human stories. We don't connect with, you know, this product being great or that brand being great and so on and so forth. Classic example is the Google story that they told about the Indian and Pakistani friend, and which we all, you know, have seen online. That was a story. Google was interwoven into it. Every product, in fact, was interwoven into it. But it was so subtle, you focused on the larger story about the friendship between two friends across borders. Paying for a celebrity instead of paying for a great script, right? Celebrities are important, don't get me wrong. Having a celebrity definitely gets people to notice your content, but only a celebrity and not great content around it does not cut any ice in digital media. You have to have a script, a story that goes with the celebrity. So first work on the script and then think about what celebrity is gonna come, right? Being topical without being thoughtful. A lot of brands do this, you know. There is Onam that just went as a festival. There's Ganesh Chaturthi. They want to be topical, current, for the sake of being topical and current. And you are among 100 other brands on digital when you do that. How are you being thoughtful? How are you being relevant to the audience? Just saying happy Ganesh Chaturthi is not going to cut it. Every brand does that. So, if you are not thinking through your content and just being topical for the sake of it, you will be another me too, another herd. So that's a mistake you should avoid. Right? More content does not mean more eyeballs. You know, I run a digital agency, and one of the things that, you know, most brand marketers ask me is, how many posts will you do? They are trying to get maximum out of their digital agency in terms of content. Nobody asks me, how good will those posts be? Can you guarantee us that? Can you make one amazing piece of content every month and we'll pay you for that? That doesn't happen. So the point is, it's not how much content you are creating. It's how good the content is that matters. Right? Creating great content, and this is, you know, half the battle won, actually. If you've created a really nice piece of content, it could be just a Facebook post. It may not be a complete film of 3 minutes. But then not distributing it enough. This is a mistake a lot of good marketers make because they don't plan their budgets. They don't see opportunities where there are. Good content and sometimes great content comes very rarely. When it comes, you should throw the kitchen sink at it because you know now you got not only the brand promise right, but the storytelling right. This works with the audience, but then you just post it on your social platforms and you don't put monies behind it so that more people see it. And what you're really doing is you're, you know, you know there's gold somewhere under this ground, but you're not digging hard enough to make sure that you, you know, take it out and distribute it to everyone, right? That's the challenge. You have to make sure that the moment you know that you've got good content on your hands, make sure you have at least 6 times what you spent on creating that content, promoting that content. 1:6 ratio is what I recommend. Paying for influencers but not having a strategy. A lot of brands actually get influencers on board and then either depend on their creation capability to create content or just create one creative, one content, all the influencers are posting the same content. There's no strategy, right? Clearly, that's the biggest mistake you can make. So when you are getting influencers on board, make sure that you have a strategy as to how each of these influencers are going to create content that looks it's coming from them, as well as it's also having the right tonality, the right content, the right social references so that it spreads through them and they are just not posting it because you paid them some money, right? So that's another mistake that you should avoid. Spending on content tie-ups but not spending enough on crafting the message. So you know, you go to a Scoop, you go to a other content platforms like that, maybe a BuzzFeed, but you've not crafted the message, you know, with them and worked with them to see how this will be intelligent. Either you're going purely for those clickbait articles or you are trying to put your brand and integrate in it very strongly so that you get maximum coverage within that article. But you've not thought through, okay, how is the reader going to react to it? What is he going to feel when he reads it? And that's very important. Focusing more on what to say than how to say it. I can't stress this enough. Treatment is very, very, very important. How you treat a particular content, how you package it, how you showcase it, makes a lot of difference. And very little time goes into that, right, after you've figured out what the message is. Finally, focusing more on the content calendar. You know, we want next 3 months, we've decided this. But what is your approach to the content strategy? How your tone is going to be? How you are going to engage? What is the audience going to feel? And I'll just come to that feeling now. According to me, content needs to make these feelings come out, and that's great content. If the consumer is seeing your content, and if he feels amazed. Example is Jean-Claude Van Damme with the split on those two Volvo trucks. Whoever saw that globally, we were in awe, right? The way he did it, it's amazing, right? That's why people shared it. That's why it was a globally famous video or piece of content, right? Are you entertained, right? Is it making the consumer feel interested to know more, interested to, you know, talk about it, right? Optimistic, if it feels optimistic, it's a feel-good factor. When somebody sees the video, it puts a smile on his face. And understood, so it makes him identify with himself that, yes, I know this. This relationship between a mother-daughter shown in this piece of content is very similar to my relationship with my mother. That's an example of being understood, right? So these things allow people to connect with content and share it further. I had a few videos to show you, but in the interest of time, I'm just going to show you a few last couple of videos. So this is some work that we did for Mother Dairy, and very recently, Social Samosa posted Mother Dairy Ice Cream is the new Amul of social media. Go check this out on the site Social Samosa. It has all the content that we've created. It's worth looking at it. It has a lot of influence from Game of Thrones, so all of you Game of Thrones fans out there, you must check this out. I'm going to show you something else. Can we play this video, please? This is the work that we did for Bajaj Allianz for their various insurance products. And can we play the video, please?
Oh my God, kitna traffic hai? Kya fayda itna luxurious hone ka?
Oh, chup, tu off-road karna phir. Wah, traffic nahi milti.
Kya thoka hai, boss? Excuse me, kaun si gaadi ko, as you said, thoka hai? I hope it's not the Silver Lux hatchback who convertible.
Arey, wahi wala hai, taxi ghusa diya.
Oh my God!
अरे बड़े-बड़े पार्किंग में छोटे-छोटे एक्सीडेंट होते रहते हैं सेनोरिता। इंश्योरेंस है ना? ए इंश्योरेंस है ना?
बड़ी अजीब बात है। आपके पास आज भी इंश्योरेंस नहीं है? आज ही लीजिए बजाज अलियंस कार इंश्योरेंस।
ट्रैफिक से भागने का इंश्योरेंस से नहीं क्यों उस्ताद
सही बोला छोटू
सो this was a series of video and content we created where inanimate objects came to life. It's the treatment. It was the art direction that actually worked for this. It also got covered by Ads of the World globally. That's it for me. Thank you so much for having me for this. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed, Rajiv.